Hi, I'm Natasha Antonioni with Austin Life, and today I'm taking you on an organizational journey with me. Have you guys seen that show, The Home Edit, on Netflix? Well, I was watching that show and I felt like I wanted to have something similar done to my closet. It's like, I like my office very neat and my house neat as well. My closet, on the other hand, needed a little help. Now, it's not the worst closet you've ever seen, but it definitely needed some improvement. I have this wonderful guy, Michael, in my life, and he has a company called Simply by Michael. And he basically is like a home concierge or organizational expert. So he can come in, and I often give him as a gift to my clients. So he'll come in and organize your pantry when you're moving in, or your closet. He's also certified by the Container Store, so he can also help you shop there, or he can do the shopping for you. So I called Michael in and had him help me with my closet. So here was my 5 takeaways. Number 1, Michael recommended that I get a valet. So I was that kid that liked to lay my clothes out on the bed the night before school. So it kind of feels like that again. It's like I have the energy before I go to bed. I just pick out the outfit because I'm kind of thinking about my day for the next day. And it just makes it like one step smoother in the morning between getting the kids together, planning my workday, and all of that. It sounds silly, but it's a little thing that just kind of helps smooth out that morning. Number 2, my closet is color coordinated again, and it's thinned out. So we went and we took those thick wooden hangers, we got the thinner hangers, and I have so much more space in my closet, as well as I was able to donate a bunch of the clothing, and we donated it to Dress for Success, which is an organization that helps women get back on their feet and get back into the workforce. So I felt really good about that as well. And I'm basically a control freak. It gave me back a sense of control in my space. It was the last kind of space in my life besides my pantry, which is next, that needed to be tidied up. The question is, when you do these things, will you maintain it? So it's been about a month now, and I would say that I'm at about a 98% mark with keeping it tidy. It's like he put the organizational systems in place, and now I'm finding that I can maintain it. So would it be something that you continually maintain, or would you need to have him come back? I would say maybe once a year he could come back. This round, for some reason, I'm feeling like I can maintain it, so I may not need that. But I do feel like having an expert come in and really help you put the systems in place is everything. And it does kind of make you feel like when you spend those extra dollars to hire an expert, that it really makes you want to maintain that moving forward. So I would say it's worth every single penny. It takes you beyond your own organizational level, and it really is kind of this gift to yourself where it's kind of like you taking care of you. So I hope that that makes sense. So come see what Michael did with me in my closet.
Okay, so when we were building this house, it was meant to be an Airbnb house.
Okay.
So we made these 2 small closets, one for Dario, one for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm definitely not the woman that should have a small closet.
When you walk into a space, it needs to have that calming presence.
Mm-hmm.
It needs to feel like not panic stressed,
right,
discolored. Because a lot of times you're in the morning, you're rushing, you don't have time to look for the scarf that you're looking for.
Yes.
So you need to know where your scarves are.
Well, check out where my jeans are. They're all hidden because I don't have enough space. They're all hidden back here.
Yes.
And then when I go to look for them, I pull the shirts down and then the shirts end up like a disaster.
Yes. Yes.
So it's like really kind of crazy.
When we look at any space, I talk about prioritizing. The spaces that you can reach, that's the prime real estate.
Right.
The spaces up top are really for storage and things that you might use on occasion.
Mm-hmm.
And then when living in the spaces, so let's say you had another shelf and we put more purses up there and it's full, that's when I encourage, okay, well, I got a new purse, I have to get rid of one. Mm-hmm. So you have to sit there and say, okay, what can I get rid of?
I can see a few right now.
Part of organizing is knowing that you need to, I call it zhuzh, you need to zhuzh every once in a while and fix it, because it does get out of whack. Because inevitably, everybody does this. It's, oh my God, so-and-so's coming over. Shove, 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 shove. We need to clean the counter. And then you go back. Like, that's the way people are.
Sure.
And so knowing that as an organizer, it's, you know, watching those shows, it's like, yes, it's beautiful, it's great, but it's like, is that really, is that real life?
Yeah.
It's not. So I tell people, I'm like, we can do, I mean, I've done some fabulous pantries and some fabulous where I have no budget and I can just do whatever I want. Everything looks super pretty. But I tell them, like, okay, it's gonna be hard to keep it this way. And one of the things I do for clients too is I come back on a regular basis.
I like the sound of that.
And we go through this stuff again and again. So a lot of my clients are repeat clients where we're like, we go through spaces in the house, and then when things are done, then we come back and we kind of fix things.
Sure, like once a year, just come in and tidy it all.
Tidy it all up.
Get it back to where it needs to be.
Exactly. I always try to fit the solution for the space. So when I measure this, I'm gonna try to find a basket that is like
fits the whole
as close as to this as I can get. Because if I have an inch here wasted and I don't have to, I'm not gonna waste any space. I do not like to waste space. But when you are folding, there are different methods of folding that you can do that fit the basket. So depending on the size of the basket and how much room we need, we could have them rolled, we could have them standing on their side, you could roll them, and what I like to fold is basically you take the sweater, you bring it in basically to the collar line, fold it in half, and I'm doing this in the air so it's not gonna be perfect.
That's a nice roll.
And
then do that.
Fold it like this, and then you stand
them
up.
I like that, yes.
Because then you can see everything in the basket. So when you pull the basket out, you're gonna see them all lined up.
You know what's good about that too is like, it's a cold day out and you're like, I want the thicker sweater
one.
Or the thinner one or whatever. So it's like double usage.
Right, so so there are different ways to fold things, and I mean, there's three or four different methods, but that's my favorite, and I do that with sweaters, t-shirts, socks, underwear.
Socks, huh?
Because you stand them up and you fold them in thirds and you can see everything.
Yeah. What if someone's watching this video and they're not local to Austin?
Yeah, so if they're not local to Austin, I can do virtual consultations all the time. So I've done it for, started doing it for family members. And then with COVID, it was one of those things that got even more important to do. And we can talk through those things. So a lot of what I do in organizing is counseling, is talking through the process because people don't, what I've realized is that they don't inherit that skill. So I have that skill and I see things spatially, but not everybody does.
Right.
So I can look at a space and say, you should put this here and that there. I've had clients where I found, oh, you bought this shirt three times. Like literally they bought the same exact shirt three times because they didn't realize they had it. And so by color coding your wardrobe, it lets you know what colors you like. Because a lot of times you purchase things and it's subconscious that you don't realize that, oh, I like blue.
I have 15 white button downs.
Right, like you realize when you color code your wardrobe what colors you gravitate towards. So when you are buying something, you're like, I already have 25 white shirts. Maybe I should buy it in blue. So because that's not a color that I have a lot of.
Or maybe I should not buy it, actually.
Yeah, or not.
Even better.
So the next steps is really just we can do some measuring and then make lists for what you need, and then get
Over
started.
There? All
yeah.
right.
So we need six of these.
Okay.
And if you want to do two of these,
Okay.
Two of those. It's 30 inches wide, 14 inches deep, and it's the same height. We went to the store and got some completion products, so bins and baskets, and she put some of those things back away, and I'm here to kind of make sure everything looks right and to give some final suggestions for her closet. So one of the first suggestions I did was she got these nice baskets for the shelves.
I've refolded all of these jeans so that they fit in here properly. She had them sideways and some going one direction, some going the other. And one way to achieve that is by folding your jeans like this. So when you fold your jeans, you have this piece here that you can fold in, which makes the jean a little bit more narrow so you can make more room. Obviously, we want to fold things based on what works with the basket that we're using, but also with the client. So if you're a person that needs things neat and folded, great. If you're a person that just wants a basket that just to throw things in, that's okay too. It doesn't have to be perfect, but it has to work for you as the client. That's what's most important. So let's take a look at the closet. So you can see now the baskets that we put in here. These are the ones that we selected from the store that really kind of clean up the shelves versus the things folded on here. But we've kind of have this theme of things folded into the basket. And again, folding in thirds is gonna be the best solution. And we have these labels that she's going to do for the labeling. But if you're not a person that needs the label, then that's okay too. It just depends on, again, what kind of person you are. You'll see that we've stuffed the purses up top and so that they're better displayed. We've thinned out some of those as well. And we've used this basket to kind of hide some of her smaller evening wear purses. So those are all up there as well. She's thinned out her shoes. So we've gotten those more narrowed down. Everything's facing forward. And you can see that they look a lot nicer than, you know, they were before, not stacked. And we've also added these baskets up here for her belts. And so things are now rolled in here so she can actually see all the different types of belts that she has and she can categorize them. So again, it's a nice way to store things and keep things looking cleaner aligned when you walk into the space. The biggest contribution we have here is her jewelry. If you remember, it was on the back of the door. And so we thinned that out and we were able to use the stacking jewelry box, which I really, really like because you can, I'll open this up here. It allows you to really separate out your jewelry, but depending on the kind of jewelry that you like, you may want this, you may want the jewelry tray for earrings. And they stack. So if she gets more jewelry, she can always add another section based on what she buys. In here, we've thinned out, we had those wood hangers. Again, going with the same color is gonna give you a cohesive process. And you're also going to be able to color code. So we have some adjustments to do to this because we'd really wanna see the whites go into color and then dark. So lighter to darker is really a good way to go. And depending on how she likes things done, you could go just lighter to darker, you could go sleeveless lighter to darker, and then long sleeve lighter to darker, and so on. So it just depends on how she functions in the space. And we'll go from there. So you see, we still have some more hangers to do, but you can see that this actually, by taking out these hangers, it makes a lot more space. I mean, these are kind of spread out, but I mean, she has a lot more space in there than she did before. You wouldn't be able to do that with the way it was set up before. And if you look up top, she's actually thinned out her jackets as well, so which has given her more space for purses. And down the line, if she needs to, she can definitely add a shelf in there as well for extra storage space on both sides if she feels like she needs to do that. We added the pop of color on the back wall, which we tied in with the rug from the master bedroom. So it really kind of makes it bright and cheery when she walks in. When she's waking up in the morning, it kind of gives her a presence of calmness, but also you know, ready to start her day because she has everything is organized and the color adds a little pop of sunshine for her day. The valet rod is something that we have to add still. It is something that's gonna have to be custom done by a handyman, but basically what it is, it will attach to this piece here, and it's just a little rod that's gonna come out. You take two fingers and you pull it out, and what it does is it allows you to take a top and hang it here. So, and it hangs like this. So this will allow her to Let's say she wants to find a skirt that matches this. She doesn't have to hold it like I am. So she could rest it on there and then start putting skirts up to it to see what matches. She could also pick out her outfit and have it hanging there so it's ready to go in the morning so that she doesn't have to really go through the process in the morning if she has a busy day or is rushed that day. Everything's ready to go. So the valet rod is something that it's a very inexpensive thing to do, but I also feel like it's something that is very valuable. If you take dry cleaning in and you have the plastic, we want to get rid of the plastic. So you can hang all that on the valet rod, strip the plastic down, switch out the hanger, and then hang it up. So it allows you, it frees up your hands, so it allows you to do that with ease. She also had these hat boxes that we added because she had some hats just sitting on the shelf. The hat box is going to give her basically a safe place to put that, keep it dust free, and you can see how aesthetically pleasing it looks by having them on there. You can see her hat in there. So again, it keeps the dust off of it and the shape of the hat keeps its integrity of the shape. So it's a great addition to her closet rather than just having sitting on the shelf. So in these baskets, she really used it to kind of hide certain things that she wanted to keep in the closet. So this is extra bathroom items. But again, with the lid on here, you don't really know what's in here. So it's kind of a safe place to store things that you don't really need to look at every day, but it's also overflow for the bathroom. So these are great for extra storage for things or to put things that you don't use all the time. So maybe you have ski clothes or scarves or hats, things in Austin that you don't use very often, but you still need access to. So these are great because of the lids and they keep the same thing, dust out of them. But these are the items that you probably don't need very often. So now what we need to do is just kind of fix a few things in here and do some fine tuning. And then once we're done, we'll show Natasha the space.
What? Oh my God. Gosh, it's amazing. I love the bins. Like, I can't stand all that craziness. It just feels so much more cohesive.
Well, I am so grateful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
As you know, you are a gift to my clients, but I've never given myself the luxury. So I use Michael as a closing gift for my clients because he's so incredible and my clients are so happy. So how do people find you?
So you can email me, michaelvillarola@hotmail.com.
Okay.
Or cell phone, 206-730-6776.
And we'll see it on the screen right now. We'll also put it in the description below so you can come back to it. Well, if you like this video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe below because we have videos on design, real estate, and things happening around town in Austin. We will see you soon. Bye.
Bye, guys.